TV5 does have both helicopters in sight. We're talking, may I hold 1,000 feet as opposed to 900 just for clearance? Okay, half mile east of the 110. You got it for TV5. Okay, here we go. Okay. Do you know what street they're on? Southbound on Main. Yeah, southbound on Main, which is just the major east of Figueroa here. You saw him exit the 110 freeway there as those CHP units were continuing on the fast track lanes here. So he managed to get off the freeway here and make an eastbound turn. And now he is going to be southbound again on Main Street. This guy has been known over the course of the pursuit here, has been known to be traveling at speeds in excess of 100 miles an hour. So rather high speeds and dangerous conditions here, especially on surface streets. PD, I do heavy there. I'm holding 1,000. So you can imagine the danger to the public here. It is just a very intense situation here, very dangerous situation where this guy is just continuing southbound on Main Street. We are trying to give the LAPD as well as the Sheriff's Department a little bit of room here, so our shot is going to be a tiny bit long, but we are going to do what we can to maintain the shot here, but we're, again, trying to give these two helicopters their proper clearance so that they can do what they need to do. The CHP is on the ground, and they are in pursuit of this guy, and I imagine the LAPD might be standing by at some point here to step in, because this is certainly their jurisdiction here. You saw him make an eastbound turn, and he is still moving along the residential area here, and the residential neighborhood here, moving eastbound. Don't know whether or not this person knows or is familiar with this particular area here, but this is kind of an off-the-beaten-path here for someone coming out of Pomona in a stolen vehicle. So we'll see kind of what this guy attempts to do here. He's just now coming up on a major where he's going to make a left or a right turn here. It's going to be a left turn, and that's going to be eastbound on a major here, and we'll try and get that sorted for you. But again, this person just now driving at a very high rate of speed, eastbound on gauge is what we understand here, and we will be coming up on another major intersection here in just a moment. He's going to be making kind of a sweeping right turn where he's going to run into some slower traffic. What's he going to do? He's going to go into the wrong lanes of traffic. Okay, so wrong way driver there. Woo-hoo, coming up to a vehicle trying to make a left turn, and he is now southbound from gauge on the major street here. And we do have, again, units of the CHP who are still in relative close proximity to this person here. So now, unknown what the situation is as far as who is in the vehicle here. Is it just a driver? Is there an additional suspect here? We will try and ascertain that over the course of the next several minutes here. Again, we are trying to maintain a certain amount of clearance here for the sheriff's helicopter as well as the LAPD helicopter, who are both overhead and trying to do what they are doing here. But again, you can see this person doing everything he or she can to avoid having to stop and pull over. Again, what is believed to be a stolen vehicle here, a stolen silver-colored Silverado, is now southbound, moving through South L.A., and looking to make that westbound turn now, just north of a high school, it looks like here. And again, just a quiet residential street with a pursuit that is now coming through the neighborhood at a fairly high rate of speed here now. I can tell you that additionally, there is only one unit of the CHP who is in relative close proximity here. So the only ground unit that you're seeing is the one directly behind him now. This guy obviously being tracked by us in Sky 5 HD, as well as the LA County Sheriff's Department, as well as an LAPD airship above. So we will try and do our best to maintain our visual with him, but you can see, given our distance here, he's kind of moving in and out of some of the buildings here. Again, moving southbound here over towards, ultimately, will be the 105 freeway in about 2 to 3 miles here. So we'll kind of track this and see where it goes. Again, I don't know if this is an area of familiarity to this person here, but again, having made its way all the way from the Pomona area, westbound on the 10 freeway, speeds in excess of 80 to 100 miles an hour, over to the 110 freeway, and now through South LA over on the east side of the 110 freeway. Another major he's going to be having to negotiate here. Okay, crosswalk, pedestrian traffic, now making an eastbound turn. He's going to be coming towards us, so I'm just going to move a little bit south and kind of circle around him here. So you can see what's going on. Just a very fluid situation here where this guy is now encountering slower traffic. He's got traffic up ahead. He's either going to go straight. Yeah, there you go. Okay, so he's going to go straight through the intersection here, again, through the residential area in a very dangerous situation where he is traveling at excessive speeds here without any regard, literally, to some of the other traffic, some of the other vehicles on the street, as well as pedestrians. So he's now coming up on a vehicle that is moving a little bit slower than he or she, for that matter. And he's just going to go take the opposite lanes of traffic here and go right around. So there you go. This person doing anything he or she can to avoid having to stop and basically give up to the authorities here. Guys, let me send it back down to you for a moment. Okay, I've got you there. North Central. TV 5 copies. I'll call for it. Okay, make it a westbound turn. Yep. Here we go. Okay, so yeah, we just turned westbound from Central here. I'm going to go ahead and have Rich turn on Skyview 5 for us here, and so we can actually lay out some of the streets for you here. We're along 79th Street now, making a northbound turn. Northbound turn. You can see Skyview 5. A little bit in our shot there, and that's going to be our mapping overlay here, which kind of shows you the direction of travel as he's going northbound now, northbound at a fairly high rate of speed, and that is going to be northbound from 79th. He's over towards 76th Street on McKinley Avenue here, so that's kind of where we are. We're about maybe a mile and a half east of the 110 freeway, the Harbor Freeway, and again, don't know if this is an area of familiarity here, but he has kind of been making large circles around this particular area here, south of the Postal Annex here. Now a westbound turn. We're going to be along 74th Street, 74th Street westbound. Again, a very residential neighborhood here, and you know what? I'm going to tell you something. We're just coming up on an area that we just circled around about 5 minutes ago, so I am guessing this might be an area that might be familiar to this person here. We're not too far from a high school, just in fact a couple of blocks to the west, as he makes a southbound turn, or a southbound transition there. Hang on just a moment, and we're going to do our best to ID this for you here, but he's now coming up on 76th Street, and let's see, bear with me here, guys. That is it, Fremont High School. So Fremont High School, he just circled around about 5 minutes ago here. So he is definitely working in this general vicinity here, kind of making circles. So this, again, as I mentioned, might be an area of familiarity. He might know the area, he might know the neighborhood. He might be looking for friends or lookouts or what have you here. So I'm sure the LAPD as well as the CHP are going to be anticipating this particular situation here as he moves eastbound over towards the major intersection here. So hang on just a moment. That's going to be Central Avenue once again. Central Avenue once again. He's just coming up on it, and now a southbound turn. A southbound turn on Central, and that's kind of where we are right now. We're remaining in this general vicinity, it appears, and we'll see what this guy chooses to do here. Looks like he may be in the left turn pocket, and that's what he's doing. Left turn into the neighborhood. And again, we'll just try and maintain a safe distance away from some of the other helicopters that are now starting to show up. But okay, he's just kind of weaving in and out of the neighborhood here. Now, for what it's worth, I do not have any units of law enforcement behind him, but we do have several helicopters that are now above him, including that Sheriff's Department helicopter that has been tracking him since he was along the 10 freeway westbound out of Pomona here. So the Sheriff's Department helicopter has been doing great work in trying to monitor this guy's activities here. So again, he's going to have to make a left or a right turn. It's going to be a right turn, it appears, and we'll kind of track that, and he's going to make his way back towards Central. Back towards Central. You can see he has kind of been circling this general vicinity here. And now northbound, northbound, I believe that's going to be Central. So Central Avenue here, and we're just kind of making circles in the area. Okay, I've got you. Again, northbound on Central, so you can see this person is just kind of actively kind of making orbits in the general vicinity here, large circles around the blocks. And he's now just going to be passing two units of the, I believe that's going to be LAPD. So they kind of, are anticipating this guy's actions in terms of, you know, working in the general vicinity here. He's northbound on Central. He's just a couple of blocks shy of the postal annex. And so there he is making that same left turn. So, again, an area that I believe is familiar to him. Now, we are, again, going to be on one of the 76th Street. Yeah, 76th Street. So there you go. So I would assume that this person kind of knows this particular area here or is waiting. Okay, just ahead of him at the cross. We're going to have three units of LAPD who were waiting for him, essentially, there. So, again, yeah, the law enforcement folks on the ground are definitely anticipating this guy's moves and trying to get ahead of him, hopefully, and perhaps an attempt to get this guy stopped. But this guy is, again, just circling this same neighborhood about one block east of Fremont High School here. He's coming up on cross traffic, on slower traffic, on opposing traffic, and he's just on a kind of a narrow street there, and you can see him kind of making his way down Stanford Avenue here, and that's going to be the 7700 block, perhaps the 7800 block. Wow, my goodness, okay, it looks like, he's moving into a position here. Bear with me here. Five's going to move a little bit to the south here, guys. Five's going to move south. Okay, he's going to be moving into a position where he's a little bit steep under us here, so bear with us. Okay, now northbound. Okay, I've got you. Northbound Wadsworth, east on 79th. Okay. It's a scary situation, I would have to believe, especially if you're a pedestrian walking along the sidewalks or even in a car, you know, having to watch this guy go past you at 80 miles an hour here. So southbound on Central, he's going to be coming up on a major here. At that major, it's going to be a stop sign with other vehicles that are actually stopped. He's going to have to go into the left turn pocket to actually get through, but that looks like what he's going to do here. So he's going to be now westbound on Manchester. He's slowly creeping southward here. The circles that he is making over on the east side of the 110, slowly getting bigger, slowly. Okay. He's going through a parking lot here, through the parking lot there, and back into the residential area here. He's going to be southbound on Wadsworth Avenue here. So, and now a westbound turn. So I can tell you that he is just kind of weaving in and out a lot of the neighborhoods here, a lot of the neighborhood streets, and so kind of what we're faced with right now. So he's moving out of the area that he had been circling before, about a mile south of it at this point here, but still continuing the pursuit southbound on that small residential street here. So that's kind of, bear with me. Okay. So, again, moving southbound, we do have a couple of units who are in relative close proximity, but they are really relying upon the air units above to kind of maintain visual on the suspect here as he makes his way through South L.A. So, just now coming up on the intersection here, it's a residential area. He's made an eastbound turn on 92nd Street is what you're looking at there. And he is kind of continuing and fairly high rates of speed, as you can see here. Now, it's scary enough when you see a guy traveling 80, 90, 100 miles an hour on the freeway here, weaving in and out of traffic. But, you know, when he's doing the, oh my goodness, wow, look at that. Okay, so when you see the same on surface streets, it's just, it's scary. I mean, so you would have to think that some of the folks who are being endangered on the streets are kind of worried at what they see here, especially if they see this guy making the rounds here, coming around the block a couple of times here. So kind of something that we're watching. He's back northbound on Central, so he's kind of targeting Central Avenue here, and he is again northbound on Central. making his way through the numbered streets from about the 8s right now. 82nd, I believe, is where he's going to be coming up on. There's Firestone Boulevard if you look at our Skyview 5 mapping. Again, in opposing lanes of traffic just to get around slower traffic here. And that, all right. So, yeah, just a desperate act there, just traveling the way he is. So, again, moving northbound on Central and back towards that general vicinity in the 70s, in the numbered street of the 70s here, 76, 75th, 74th, kind of moving in that general vicinity along Central here. So if he makes a left turn along one of those 70s here, we'll just kind of know, again, that he's basically circling that same general vicinity here as he makes his way. We're about four blocks north of the south of the Postal Annex as he makes his way northbound here. And again, there's that left-hand turn, that westbound turn along this time 78th Street. So, yeah, just this general vicinity here, and I would imagine that the police and the CHP kind of know that this person is generally targeted. Okay, I can see a couple of things happening up ahead here. So he's going to have to make, he can go straight through the intersection, and that's what he's doing there. But I can see a couple of units here in relative close proximity here. So there are law enforcement units that are staging generally in the neighborhood here. And I'm not going to give their locations away, but rest assured they do know that this guy is in the general area here. We're just now coming up on the eastern edge of Fremont High School here, and he's going to have to make a left or right turn, and that's going to be a northbound turn along Avalon Boulevard here from, I believe that was 79th or 78th, but again, a northbound turn, and there's the high school over on the left, and as he makes his way up, he's going to gain a little bit of speed there and kind of accelerate past or away from some of the officers who are trying to keep this guy in their sights, essentially, here. So he's coming up on a red light in about 100 yards there, and he's, again, in the wrong lanes of traffic. Very dangerous situation there, and he makes that westbound turn. Westbound turn along Florence. And that's what we're looking at there. So again, just a very dangerous situation here. The law enforcement units on the ground are doing their best to maintain a visual on him, but certainly a situation where they are relying upon the airships to keep an eye on this guy and his activities here. So westbound, and he is essentially heading towards, he's just crossed over Main Street. He's going to be coming up on Broadway and ultimately the 110 freeway here. So we'll see what he decides to do. Is he going to be moving out of the neighborhood here? We will know in the course of a few minutes here. So he's going to be coming up on a red light here shortly. Stop traffic just ahead. How's he going to get around him? He's going to go over to the slow lane. Oh, my goodness. Okay, the slow lane of traffic there. And he's just going to be coming up on that right turn northbound, here. So you're kind of watching along with us. That's going to be Main Street northbound here. And again, just kind of trying to accelerate beyond the LAPD and CHP units who are chasing him, guys. So let me send it back to you for just a moment. Okay. Oh, yeah, very close call there. Now turning northbound on Main Street, kind of zigzagging around the general vicinity here, just a couple of blocks east of the 110 freeway here, so you can kind of see him weaving in and out trying to avoid having to slow down to stop here or avoid even being pitted for that matter there. You can see he's kind of accelerating through there. I believe he's going to be on 69. Thank you, Rich. 69th Street moving eastbound. Now the LAPD has kind of taken over from the air at the very least here and certainly on the ground. And now a northbound turn. We'll get that for you. That's going to be San Pedro from 69th. Northbound San Pedro at 69th, and you can see that he is kind of doing his best to accelerate away. I can't tell you there are at least, three units behind him, immediately behind him, as well as helicopters overhead here. So a situation where it would be exceedingly difficult for him to actually get away here. So in that he is kind of circling the general vicinity here, it is, hopefully a safe assumption that he might get caught at some point here. But hopefully he will do the right thing and just kind of give up and slow down, stop, and bring this to an end here. This is just an exceedingly dangerous situation where he is just accelerating at pretty high rates of speed here and, doing some pretty bad things here in that he is going in the opposing lanes of traffic, weaving in and out like he's doing right now. And he's just now coming up on the major intersection here. We're just about a block to the west of the postal annex. And he's going to make, making that eastbound turn. Eastbound turn on Florence. So we're just coming up on the postal annex over on the left side, and he's just kind of accelerating away. We do have at least those three, and make that an additional unit, a fourth unit, a fifth and a sixth unit now, in fact, that are chasing him on the ground, as well as LAPD above here. Sky 5 HD, we've been with this pursuit for several minutes at this point here, and now he is just kind of making his way over towards that same neighborhood here. So if he heads over to Central and makes a southbound turn, and that's what he's doing there. Okay, so he is circling back to that same neighborhood here, south of the postal annex, southbound from Central. Five's got everyone. And now kind of making that same turn here, now passing 74th. We'll see if he makes a right turn into the neighborhood here like he had been doing. But we do know that he has been, as far south from here, it's about a mile and a half. So generally speaking, working this same neighborhood here. So we've been watching that over the course of the past 10 to 15 minutes. But he now continues southbound past the intersection there. And again, several units of the LAPD still in relative close proximity to this guy as he tries to accelerate through here. So the initial want, from what we understand, a stolen vehicle coming out of Pomona. So with the stack of charges that are being added to that initial charge here, we can see that he is just doing whatever he can to avoid having to slow down and stop for these guys. But he's made that eastbound turn off of Central here, and he's going to have to, he's going to make a northbound turn. So there you go, northbound turn on Hooper from 89th, and he is now again northbound coming back our way here. So we're only one major east of Central Avenue, which had been kind of a corridor that he has been utilizing for the past 15 to 20 minutes. But again, work in the same general vicinity here off of the Central Avenue corridor here between, say, the 60s and the 80s in terms of number streets here. But he's now up on a red light here, and he's, again, using that left turn pocket. And he's going to be making that westbound turn coming towards us here. And he is west on Nadeau, and coming back in towards that same area here. So we'll kind of see what he does. I'm right over Central, so if he makes that left turn, he's going to be right under us here. So we'll see what he does. Is he going to go right past Central? He's going to go past Central. And go ahead. I would think so. If they can anticipate his moves, and as we were talking about before, being in that general vicinity, I believe that they are trying their best. I did see a couple of units who were deployed in the neighborhood here. I don't know that they were carrying spike strips, but yeah, that is certainly an option here. Given the fact that we are on some very tight surface streets here, and there are civilians, and there are other vehicles here in terms of traffic. A pit maneuver might be in order at some point here, but I would say on a narrow street like this, given the speeds that he's traveling at, something north of about 35, 40 miles an hour, speeds in excess of 60, 70, 80 that we have seen, a pit maneuver might not work out in these residential areas here. But we'll kind of track it, and we'll see what he chooses to do here. But again, we're going right around Fremont High School here. So, given that fact, we are just kind of doing what we can to maintain vigil. He's just past northbound along the west side of Fremont High School here. So again, just work in the same neighborhood around Fremont High School and just to the east of it here. So going through the intersection there and kind of just bringing us along for the ride at this point here. But again, several units of the LAPD are in very close proximity to him, as well as the LAPD airship above, and they are going to do their very best to maintain their visual on him so that they don't lose him at any point. But again, he is doing his very best to just avoid having to even slow down at this point and give up peacefully here. A southbound turn. I believe that's going to be Main. Okay, went up on the curb, back down. He's going to be southbound on Main. And there you have kind of a line of law enforcement officers, the LAPD, who are in very close proximity to him. And so he is coming up on slower traffic. He's making turns through the neighborhood here. He is basically coming our way. And let me just move a little bit to the north here so he doesn't go right underneath us. But again, coming into the same neighborhood here, I would have to believe that this guy definitely knows kind of where he is or the general vicinity here. So we're just about a block, maybe two blocks north of Fremont High School. Again, that same neighborhood here. And he's now pulling in to a parking lot or a throughway, perhaps. There's the LAPD airship above. Okay, he's gone through an alley. And it's about to make that westbound turn. Oh, opposing lanes. Okay, head on traffic. At an intersection. Okay. And the LAPD essentially collapsing on him from all directions at this point here. So they are definitely moving and staging in the general vicinity should he return to this area here. It looks like he has been circling the neighborhood here for quite some time at this point here. But now again, a westbound turn. We're going westbound over towards, we've passed Main and over towards Broadway. So beyond Broadway, of course, is going to be the 110 freeway, and there is an on-ramp to the 110 freeway, at least if you wanted to go northbound. That is kind of where he came from, and it looks like he's going to be southbound. Oh my goodness, okay, that was a close one here. Southbound on Broadway is kind of where we are here from the numbered streets in the 70s, I believe. Okay, we're going to move a little bit southwest here. I do have you. And again, staying in the area here, guys, so you can see what he's doing. He's just kind of weaving in and out and staying in this general vicinity east of the Harbor Freeway here, guys. If you don't mind, I'll send it back to you for just a moment. Whoa, okay, yeah. Wow. Northbound on Main. 69. Okay, I've got you. Wow, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sorry, Rich. Thank you. Five copies, we're at 1,000. Okay, westbound turn. Okay. We're back up Main Street here, guys, from 89th. We made a westbound turn on 89th and now a northbound turn on Main Street here. Main Street is just two blocks east of the 110 freeway here, and he's making his way back up the numbered streets, you know, 80s, 70s, and now he is, again, northbound. So we're just coming up on a major intersection. That's going to be Manchester. He's going to kind of weave his way through some cross traffic there, a very dangerous situation, but you can kind of see what he's doing there. He's trying to accelerate away from the LAPD. I can tell you there's more than half a dozen units of the LAPD on the ground in relative close proximity as well, of course, as the LAPD airship and Sky 5 HD. So you can imagine, my goodness, this guy is just doing everything he can to just avoid slowing down here. So just a very, very dangerous situation here as he makes his way back up towards. Are we in the 70s? Yeah, we're going to be in the 70s in terms of streets here. Northbound on Main Street, back up towards 79th, and just about two blocks to the west of Fremont High School, just to give you a point of reference there. But again, we are moving northbound up on an intersection, and he's going to go through it. And I can tell you that the LAPD is, again, several units that are in relative close proximity here, and he's going to be coming up on some slower traffic here. Slower traffic, and in fact, a red light in about a block and a half here, so we'll see what he does. Hang on just a moment. Okay. Now coming up, oh my goodness, okay, so just in the opposing lanes of traffic, he's got a red light. He's going to make that turn, and that's going to be an eastbound turn, Now he's back on Florence from Main Street, eastbound Florence from Main, and he's definitely coming up on stop traffic there, and he's going to go around the outside. Woo! Okay. Thank you for that, Rich. Thank you for that. Okay, you can see this guy's kind of ducking in, moving in and out. I believe he's gone through the parking lot of a gas station here. So is he going to come out? There he is. Now southbound, and that's going to be, I've got you there. And that's going to be Pedro, San Pedro Street, southbound through the numbered streets. We're talking about the 70s now, 72nd, 73rd, 74th, just one block to the west of Fremont High School. So again, this area that we believe that he might be familiar with, but again, traveling fairly fast, southbound, and just kind of weaving in and out of slower traffic, of stop traffic. Okay, he's got a situation up ahead. Woo! Okay, that person was able to move to the right there. Oh my gosh. Okay, so there you go. Again, moving southbound, and my guess is that he'll take us southbound towards the 80s and towards 90th. If things kind of hold the way they have been in this pattern of driving, he might make a turn northbound up again up near 90th. So we'll just kind of watch and wait and see what he does. But for the moment, okay, what was that? My goodness. Okay. You saw him sliding out there and basically doing a 180. He swapped ends and he's now northbound, coming at us, northbound Pedro, from about 80th right now. And he's got some slower traffic ahead. He's got cross traffic ahead, opposing traffic ahead, and he's just now going to be coming up on an intersection where he's going to have to go around the outside. Man, okay, just a dangerous situation. Can you imagine being on the streets and having this guy pass you doing something crazy like that? My goodness. Okay, so, okay. Wow, you can see what he's doing here, and just no signs of giving up, no signs of letting off, just aggressive driving the whole way through, and just, okay, he's coming up. Oh my gosh, a UPS truck, wow. Just went on the round around the outside of the UPS truck, and now he's an eastbound turn into the neighborhood here. That's going to be 73rd. So, again, in this neighborhood here, we'll see what he does, but again, we're just kind of making circles around the neighborhood, and he's just now coming up on a slower car. That car is going to pull over, and he's going to make his way around, and he is now going to be coming up on the major intersection there. So, okay, Is he trying to decide what he's going to do there? He's stopped. Okay, he's going to be northbound. Northbound Avalon. Northbound Avalon here. And again, we're going to be coming up on the major. Okay. He's trying to force his way through, and so he kind of did that and is now eastbound. Eastbound on Florence again. And again, this is an area that we have passed by before just a few minutes ago, just on the south end of the postal annex. And he's making an eastbound turn. And again, units of the LAPD in a relative close proximity. They're laying about maybe half a block behind him at this point. But again, the air unit directly above, and they're kind of keeping tabs on where this guy's going. So we'll keep an eye on it as well. In the meantime, guys, I'm going to turn it over to you for just a moment. Okay, I've got you there. We're at 1,000. Should be Broadway. Oof. Okay, thank you. Yeah, that's the 110 freeway. That's the Harbor Freeway, and he just kind of went westbound right under it from Gage and the 110 freeway here. So whether or not he popped, okay, he's on the freeway southbound, Rich. He's on the freeway. He's on the freeway southbound. Hang on with us for just a moment. There you go. There you go. So he's now southbound on the 110 freeway. So he made his way westbound on Gage over to the 110 freeway. And from the 110 freeway, he crossed under and entered the southbound lanes of the 110 freeway. And that's kind of what we're tracking at this point here. So he is back on the freeway, guys. You know, we had been coming through South L.A. here in this neighborhood for the better part of 30 minutes or so, and now he has re-entered the freeway. And keep in mind that when this thing was coming out of Pomona as a reported stolen vehicle, the speeds were in excess of 80, 90, and 100 miles an hour along the 10 freeway. Along the 10 freeway westbound here. So he made his way 10 freeway westbound over to the 101, and it has just been a ride from then until this point now. So again, we are now again southbound on the 110 freeway. We're going to be coming up to the 105 in a matter of about a mile and a half or so, and we will kind of watch and see what he does. He's been taking us on quite a ride this morning, but again, just an exceeding. I've got you. Thanks, Alden. Just a very dangerous situation where this guy is, not afraid to turn it on and drive aggressively and kind of lead us along a chase here down the 110 freeway over towards the 105. So moving out of that area that we thought that he might be familiar with, that he has been circling for the past 20, 30 minutes. But, okay, did he get hit as he was trying to cross over? Okay, wrong way driver, wrong way driver, wrong way driver. Wrong way driver, hang on. We got a wrong way driver on the southbound 110. Okay, this is gonna be dangerous here where he could end up in a situation where he goes head on with someone here. So a wrong way driver, he is going northbound on the southbound 110, and you can see he's crossing right over 95th. He's in the right shoulder, utilizing that right shoulder. Obviously, units of the LAPD are not gonna be able to track him. We are tracking him, the LAPD airship is tracking him. But you saw him spin out there, and now he, oh, okay, he's got it. My goodness, okay, a car that was stalled in that right shoulder here, and now he is continuing northbound in southbound lanes of the 110 freeway here. So this is going to be just a very, very dangerous situation here. He has an opportunity to get off the freeway. We'll see if he utilizes that. He's now coming up on the on-ramp. I believe this is going to be Manchester, but okay, there you go. He just crashed. He just crashed into someone there. He's going to try and back out of this. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so he backs out of this. Wow, you just saw that. My goodness here. He is getting off on the on-ramp here on the southbound side of the 110 freeway at Manchester here, at Manchester. He's now made that turn. He's now back on surface streets, and he's going to be encountering LAPD going the other way. Those LAPD units are going to have to cross over the island here and head the other way, because there he is coming out, and he is not, well, he can't so... Okay, he's going to stay on surface streets here, and several units of the LAPD and CHP are in relative close proximity here, but they are facing the wrong way here. Now, he is eastbound on Manchester, just crossed Broadway. He's going to be coming up on Main Street. He has a red light that just turned green, but a lot of slower traffic. I believe this is only going to be two or three lanes available to him. He's going to utilize a parking lot and the sidewalk to try it. Oh, okay, what is he going to do here? Okay, he's just utilizing the sidewalk now. And he's going to cross over the main, well, he's at Main Street, I believe. He's at Main Street. I think he's going to be turning northbound on Main from Manchester. So, woo, that sequence of events that we've seen in the last 3 to 4 minutes, just wow, my goodness, that is a dangerous deal here. So now he's still accelerating at some pretty high rates of speed here. But the LAPD, again, picking him back up with 5 units that are in relative close proximity. They're hanging back about half a block, maybe a block or so. And the air unit, the LAPD air unit, and Sky 5HD, we are directly over, kind of watching his actions here. So now he's along Main Street northbound, back into the 80s and now into the 70s that we had seen him just a few minutes ago. So he is, again, working this neighborhood here, a couple of blocks west of Fremont High School, northbound on Main Street. He's in the 70s and just heading northbound over towards Florence. So, again, not afraid to use the wrong lanes of traffic here. You saw him doing that on the 110 freeway here, just a radical display of driving here, just very aggressive and just doing anything he Okay. He's got opposing traffic. Wow. He's got a slower vehicle ahead of him here, and so he's trying to do what he can to make his way around that work truck here, but that work truck is not letting him go, and maybe not realizing what is going on here. He's just coming up on Florence, and now he's going to go right through the intersection there. So continuing northbound on Main Street past Florence, and again, this is that neighborhood that he had been circling for the better part of 30 minutes here, and he just essentially kind of came right back to it. He's making an eastbound turn over on 69, over on 69 eastbound from Main, and now heading into the residential area, a couple of blocks ahead of him, the postal annex. And you can see that cross traffic. Okay, wow. He's now southbound. Again, working this same neighborhood here, guys. Boy, that sequence of driving that we just saw over the course of the last 5 minutes or so was exceedingly dangerous there. Southbound on the 110 freeway, then spinning out and utilizing the right-hand shoulder to go the wrong way northbound. So then colliding head-on with that vehicle who was just trying to get on the freeway from Manchester. So he has actually made his way back to this same area here. We're just one block west of Fremont High School. We're now southbound on Pedro, and again in the 70s. I think 76th is where we are at here, and looks like he wants a U-turn here. If he U-turns, it's one lane of traffic, and that's going to be tied up. Okay, he's going to go in that left turn pocket and go straight through the intersection there, and you basically pass all those LAPD units that were that are chasing him. Now the LAPD units are trying to turn around and reacquire, and he's now making his way up to Florence. And at Florence, where he is at right now, okay, it's going to be an eastbound turn on Florence from Pedro. So just an unpredictable drive from this guy, given the fact that he's working the same general area here. That might be the only predictable thing about him, but just you never know where he's going to turn left, turn right. It's just hard to predict what this guy's going to do. We understand that some of the ground units may be authorized to utilize bike strips, but given the fact that he's driving so erratically, so unpredictably, it's hard to know what street he's going to turn on here. So I would venture to say anything south of Florence, anything east of Main Street is going to be fair game here. And we're talking about a lot of residential areas here, and you can see that he is kind of picking up speed, accelerating beyond some of the LAPD units. Bear with me here. Let me send it back to you guys for just a moment. Okay. Westbound turn on 73rd. Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah, this guy is definitely circling the same general area here. He's basically northbound Avalon, just coming up on Florence here. He might go through the intersection. My thought is that if he goes northbound, and it looks like he is, he might do what he did just a couple of minutes ago and make a turn and circle back southbound here. So right now we're north of Florence. He doesn't seem to spend much time north of Florence here before turning and then going back southbound, but we'll kind of watch and see what he does here. Generally speaking, he has been holding in the neighborhood, maybe east of Main, south of Florence, west of Central, and north of Manchester. So that kind of a grid type is what we've been following him. Right now he's actually technically outside that grid, but again, he will move north of Florence like he just did, but again, my thought is that he will likely end up turning and circling back. So now he has an opportunity for a left turn, and that's what he's going to do. He's going to be coming back down. That's going to be Pedro southbound from 68th, and now coming back down towards Florence. Does he want to make that right turn? It looks like he wants to hook a right into the residential. Okay, so he's making that westbound turn over on 69th and heading over towards Main Street. He's going to have to make a turn left or right once he does get to Main Street here, so let's see what he does here. So again, this is just that kind of that large grid pattern that I believe he's been circling here. So okay, as he comes down on Main Street, he's going to be coming up on Florence, And there are units. Okay, let's kind of watch this. Rich, widen out just a touch. Widen out just. He's going to blow through the intersection here, but there are a couple of units of the LAPD who are waiting over on the northwest corner. I believe that's a Winchell's or something. But at any rate, they were waiting for him and were preventing him basically from turning west. Okay, so maybe revealing a little bit of strategy there, but they're kind of corralling him back into the neighborhood here. So now eastbound on, hang on, let me turn around here, Florence, and now northbound. Okay, I wonder if he's got a disabled truck here or partially disabled. He had an LAPD unit here who was just facing him. So, okay, my sense is that the LAPD is kind of narrowing their scope of their perimeter there, and they kind of are tracking him in a tighter perimeter here. So he's now westbound again, westbound on, what is that going to be, 70th Rich, and he's going to be heading back towards Main, and once he gets to Main, it's going to be a left turn or right turn, and that's going to happen in just a couple of seconds here. He's going to make a right turn. It looks like he wants to make a right or a left. Okay, southbound turn, left turn, southbound, and that's going to be over towards Florence, and that's going to be towards that donut shop. Those two cops are waiting right there for him. He's going to go through the parking lot. Those are the cops that are waiting for him. Oh, my gosh. He's going to go around the backside of them. And now westbound. Westbound on Florence here. So we've seen that, but I don't know that they were able to spike him. I know they were prepared to, but I don't know that they were able to engage the spike strip. So now, again, he's just crossing over. That's going to be Broadway. And now towards the 110 freeway again here. So, guys, he can get on the 110 freeway northbound right here if he chooses. Okay, well, there you go. Is he going to stay in the neighborhood? Okay, he's going to stay in the neighborhood here. He's going to stay in the neighborhood. That's going to be Grand Avenue, which is just parallel to the 110 freeway over on the east side of it. And now he is northbound. This is going to be an area that is pretty secluded here, but he's just now coming up on another intersection where he can go straight or turn left or turn right. Now, bear with us here. He's going to go right through it. He's going to go right through it. And now he is going to join the off-ramp, I believe, here. He's going to be joining the off-ramp off the northbound 110. But it looks like he's kind of slowing down, trying to figure out what he wants to do here. Potential imminent footbill, who knows? So, again, okay, coming up on Gage, and it looks like he wants to make a left turn. So this is where we were just a few minutes ago, when he went under the 110 freeway and picked up the 110 freeway south. And so I don't know that this is a circle that he wants to make again, but it certainly is a possibility. Bear with us here. It looks like he may be entering, and there he is, 110 freeway south. And we've done this circle before. Here we go, 110 freeway southbound from Gage. Bear with us here just a moment here. Again, 110 freeway south. And again, this is something that we just saw about 10 minutes ago here. So again, entering that freeway at Gage. And it looks like he's getting off immediately here. And we'll kind of watch and see what he does. Where is he going to pop out here? Rich, bear with me just a second, Rich. Okay, and it's a westbound turn, and that's going to be Florence, guys. Back on Florence, westbound, and a northbound turn on Fig. Yeah, northbound turn on Fig from Florence here. And now he has basically worked his way over to the west side of the 110 freeway. So we have not seen that too much from this guy throughout the course of the pursuit here. But you can see, again, he's accelerating pretty quickly here. So pretty aggressive driving as he accelerates northbound along the west side of the 110 freeway. That's going to be Fig. And he's going to be heading up towards Slauson here in about maybe 3/4 of a mile or so. He can, of course, make a right-hand turn here. And it looks like he's going to do that. And that's going to be Gage. So he's back on Gage. Is he going to get on the freeway or what? Oh, my gosh. Okay, he's going to go under the freeway if I read that right. Yeah, there you go. He's popping out over on the east side. So now eastbound, again, on Gage, coming up on Broadway. Slower traffic. Stop traffic. Okay, that guy was in the left turn pocket making the left turn, and this guy was coming head on with him. So, again, we are now northbound on Broadway from Gage. And that's kind of where this sits right now. Again, LAPD hanging back about a block at this point, maybe a block and a half, but within striking distance should they decide to accelerate and meet up with this guy here. But again, my sense is that this guy at some point is going to make a southbound turn, but we'll kind of follow through and wait and see what he does here. He is northbound. Northbound on Broadway, now coming up on Slauson. Now coming up on Slauson. He's through the intersection. Wrong way driver. Wrong way of traffic there, and he is just kind of accelerating away. And there you go. We're going to make a push northbound here so we can kind of keep up with him. But, again, you can see how he is accelerating away and now moving, generally speaking, out of the area. He's probably about 3 miles away from the vicinity that he had been circling for the past 30 to 45 minutes. But, again, now we're moving into an area northbound along Broadway here, just parallel the 110 freeway. We've passed Slauson, so we will be coming up shortly. Hang on a second here, guys. He's in the shadows there, but bear with us. We're going to do what we can to maintain a relative close proximity to him. The LAPD airship, of course, is above, and they are kind of watching. LAPD ground units about a block and a half, maybe closer to 2 blocks behind him now. They're kind of tracking him. But, again, this guy is moving fairly rapidly there, and there's no need to be on the opposite side of the road, but that's what he's doing there. So, oh, my gosh. Okay, a left turn. Okay, a left turn westbound from Broadway. Over towards the 110 freeway. He is going to have an opportunity to get on the freeway here, northbound or southbound, or pass over to the west side of the 110. So now let's see what he does here. If he makes that left turn here, if he comes out, is he coming out here? Okay, there he is. If he comes out and makes a left turn, he has the opportunity for the 110 south, but it looks like he's going to go straight over to Fig. Straight over to Fig from Vernon. And he's going to continue westbound here. So, guys, let me get lined up a little bit better here. But, again, westbound on Vernon. He's basically a few blocks south of USC at this point. He should be coming up on Hoover and beyond that Vermont Avenue here. So just to kind of give you guys an idea, he's west of the 110 freeway along Vernon. And he should be crossing over Hoover and over towards Vermont, making a further trek west of the 110 freeway here. We're about maybe a mile west of the 110 freeway at this point, and he still continues west. Beyond that, we're going to be talking about areas like Western Avenue there, so we'll kind of track this guy and see what he does. But again, this is an area that we have not seen him trek to, and definitely away from that area that we believe that he was familiar with, and we had been circling for the better part of 30 to 45 minutes here. So, you know, on this track, another 2 to 3 miles will be over in Leimert Park, the Crenshaw District here, and that's kind of the direction we're headed. But we're essentially southwest of the Coliseum by about a mile, maybe a mile and a half, and we continue on this westbound trek along Vernon Avenue here, passing Normandy. We'll be coming up on a western here, and now a southbound turn. So this is curious here to see what he does here. He's behind some trees, behind a couple of buildings, but I can see him moving slowly, and he's in the wrong way of traffic there. So he was in opposing lanes of traffic here, going head-on or face-to-face with some vehicles going northbound. But he is now southbound. Airship directly above him, Sky 5HD, watching from a little bit to the northeast here as we track him southbound. And he is going to be southbound on Normandy. Around 49, we should be heading into the 50s at some point. And in terms of surface streets, and you can see that, again, he is trying to accelerate away from the LAPD units, at least on the ground, and he is relatively speaking able to do that right now. I believe they're hanging back in tracking mode, but they're doing their very best to kind of maintain visual on him from about a block and a half away here. But again, as I mentioned, the airship is above. We are a little bit north and behind, but we're doing what we can. Oh, okay, I've got you there. Thank you. We're doing what we can here to maintain visual as well. He's just now coming up on Slauson. Let's see what he does at this major. He can always go through it, but he definitely has a red light with cross traffic that he is now having to negotiate with. So let's see what he does here. Again, that's Slauson. He's going to make that eastbound turn. Eastbound on Slauson here from Normandy, heading back towards the 110 freeway. So that's what we're going to be doing right now. I've got you, hold on. Okay, eastbound on Slauson. And let's see what he does. It looks like he's slowing down to make a decision here, and he's going to be coming northbound. Oh my goodness. Okay, northbound on Budlong, and he's essentially coming right towards us here. Units of the LAPD about a block behind him, so they're following in relative close proximity here. Again, the airship above, and we are now tracking this guy as he makes his way through definitely a residential neighborhood here in South LA here, guys. He's right underneath us, brother. Although I'm pushing south a bit, I do have you. I've got you. Oof. South on Vermont. Five, four. Hoover. He'll be Hoover, southbound Hoover over to Slauson. Five, gotcha. Okay, gotcha, Aldo, thanks. Yeah, southbound on Hoover, basically, making that eastbound turn. I believe that was going to be 60th. Thanks, Rich. Eastbound on 60th, and he's basically coming up on Fig in about half a block or so, and he's slowing down a little bit here for traffic up ahead. So we'll kind of see what he's up to, but he's going to be coming up on the intersection here slowly, and he's got a decision to make here. If he goes straight, he's gonna make the northbound turn. So here we go, northbound on Figueroa, and again, coming up on Slauson, and I'm right on top of Slauson here, so he's kinda headed towards us. He's making that eastbound turn again, okay. Eastbound turn. He can go under the 110 freeway, and that's what he's going to do. So he is now back over towards the east side of the 110 freeway, and that's going to be, 59th over towards Broadway. Just now coming up on Broadway. He's got the right-of-way there, so he's going to go right through the intersection. And now proceed eastbound through the neighborhood over towards Broadway. Now at Broadway, it's a left, right, or go straight, so he has that option, all three options available to him. And he's going to be making that decision here, momentarily. So let's see what he does. It's going to be a northbound turn, maybe. I think he's trying to decide. Okay, he's got a pedestrian there that he's dealing with. So he's going to continue eastbound. Again, on 59th, through the residential. It's kind of a mixed area, residential, a little bit of industrial. But again, another block and a half or so, and we'll be back over towards, say, San Pedro, over towards those areas where it becomes a little bit more industrial here, and he'll have to make a turn to the left or to the right here in about half a block, so we'll know what he does. He's going to disappear behind a couple of buildings right about now, and we'll see where he pops out here. So it's going to be a left turn northbound or a right turn southbound. It looks like a right turn southbound. Right turn southbound on Avalon, so we've seen that before here. So now he is generally moving back into that original area here, that original kind of grid that we had been watching him make here. So he's in this industrial area here for the next couple of blocks, and it's an eastbound trek along 6-1 through the area. He's got a couple of big rigs, a couple of utility trucks that he's trying to negotiate his way around, and that is not always the easiest thing on a narrow alleyway like this is. So you can see what he's doing there. He's just kind of passing off to the left of that one work truck there. And eventually he'll bop out of the alley, and he should be over towards Central, if I'm not mistaken. We're about a block north of the Postal Annex, just to give you an idea here. He's through the alleyway, through this industrial complex. LAPD, again, maybe three or four buildings behind him. So they've pulled up on the pursuit here, so they're in relative close proximity. He's got slower traffic ahead, just now coming up on an intersection with cross traffic. I believe that's going to be Central Avenue there. He's going to make that southbound turn. And once he gets a couple of blocks south of here, he's going to be in that pocket, in that perimeter, in that zone that we had been watching him earlier. So, we're talking about Florence to the north, Main Street to the west, Central to the east, and maybe Manchester to the south. So basically, that wide square is what he had been generally driving through. And through for several minutes there, but we are on the east side of the Postal Annex along Central Avenue, southbound, and his next major intersection, it's a green light, that's going to be Florence, where he does have a few cars that are turning left in front of him, and he's slowing down for the intersection. He's going to make that right turn, that's going to be a westbound. Oh my gosh, okay, you saw that pedestrian nearly get nailed. Oh my gosh. Okay, so, do you think something went through the window, Rich? Okay, pedestrian might have some involvement there. Not sure. Rich, our Sky 5 photographer, saying that there might be some involvement with that pedestrian, perhaps something thrown in the window or something of that nature here. So, again, that's something that we will be reviewing tape on here. But, again, in front of the Postal Annex, westbound on Florence, now coming up. Hang on here. Let's see what he's doing. Is he going to go through? He is now southbound. Okay, fair enough. I've got you. Okay, southbound on Avalon here. So that'll be curious to know if that pedestrian did have some kind of an interference with the driver of this vehicle here. So that will be strange to, we'll try and review the tape on that at some point and see if there was some sort of involvement there. But again, he's right at Fremont High School. We had been watching this guy. So he's on the north side of Fremont High School, now westbound on, 76. And hang on here, he's now northbound, again, coming up on Florence here, and another block and a half. So we'll watch what he does as he plows through this intersection. He's going to be coming up on the main street here, so he's going to have to make a decision, left turn, right turn. Okay, so it looks like a passenger. Sure does. Okay, I wonder if that white truck is trying to interfere. Is that white truck trying to interfere? Okay, white truck is interfering. Okay, let me get by that guard check here. Hang on here, guys. LAPD close in behind. Let's see what happens here. They're going to box him in, and that white pickup truck certainly played a role in the stoppage of this pursuit here. That the Silverado just can't get by at this point here, so it looks like there's going to be some involvement by some civilians here. Are they going to try and push that white truck out of the way? Okay, so bear with us here. The LAPD, okay, I see smoke. Is that from the tire? Okay, so he's trying to push that white truck out of the way. The LAPD is now kind of closing in, guns drawn. Okay, oh my gosh, this guy does not want to go. Here we go. Oh gosh, okay. Rich, let's widen out just a touch. Let's widen out, because this might not end very nicely here. This white truck is definitely trying to intervene here. And the guy just kind of plows through. You saw that. And now he's back on Florence. So this is just, now kind of makes you wonder, what kind of desperate situation is this? You know, is it just a stolen vehicle, or is there something more to it at this point here? So he's got some smoke coming from the left rear of the vehicle. I wonder if that had an effect on a tire or what have you here. He just doesn't seem to be moving as fast as he was. So now, of course, you have to think about the potential for a foot bail here. In this situation, you would normally see this guy accelerating at higher speeds here, trying to get away from the LAPD. Not the case right now. He is going to be San Pedro northbound. And you can see the smoke coming from the left rear of the truck there. So I'm wondering if this truck is some way disabled here. I wonder if he's got a flat left rear tire. He's going to make that left turn into the neighborhood. That's going to be 6-9, I believe. 6-9. Okay. There you go. I don't know if we can see much of that left rear tire, but it certainly looks like it certainly looks like he's been disabled in some way here. And now he's going to be making his way westbound. And at There it goes. That tire just came loose. So this truck is it's going to be a little bit disabled here, and he's going to have to really make this truck work to make it do anything here. We have residents coming out from the left side there, maybe coming out to look. Okay. So this is going to be 69th. The one, okay, 69th and Main. He's still pushing his way to the west. Bear with us. This is all playing out as you're seeing it right here on our air. Sky 5 HD was the first overhead with this, but now you can see that smoke coming out from the left rear. The tire is gone, and now he's coming up on the Main Street here. So, again, this is going to be Main Street as he makes his left turn southbound. Left turn southbound, and he's not going to be able to maneuver as, well, definitely as he was earlier on because, well, look, he's basically on the wheel there, on the rim of that pickup truck here. So now he's made a move to the west. This is going to be inevitable that this ends at some point here. It's just how he chooses to end it. It's entirely up to him whether or not he wants to give this up peacefully or not. But again, it looks like there are two people in that vehicle, a driver and a passenger, and he's going to be what are you doing up ahead, dude? Okay, so there is he's coming up on Broadway, and there is someone backing up northbound on Broadway here in a van, and I wonder if there's some sort of okay, no, he's just backing up in okay, you see that van right there to the right, Rich? Okay, now that van is pushing forward, so okay, maybe no involvement, but I think he's just stopping to watch the action there, but okay, this guy's moving over to Grand Avenue again, and it looks like he wants to make that northbound turn. Okay, remember a few minutes ago here, as he was northbound on Grand, getting closer to Gage, he had actually slowed down, maybe considering a foot bail at some point, and that is going to be about half a mile ahead, so whether or not that is going to be a consideration for him again, who knows, but we will see. And at this point, at the rate that he is driving, the LAPD is in very close proximity here, and they are basically following. Okay, he's got an LAPD unit ahead of him, and that guy's going to let him go. Crossing through, this is going to be Grand, and he's going to be coming up on Gage, I believe. So this is something that we've seen before. It was right around here that he had slowed down to ponder perhaps a foot bail here. So don't know if that's going to happen, but I can tell you that he has been through this particular stretch before, at least once, perhaps twice. Now he's going to be meeting up with the folks who are getting off on the off-ramp here at Gage on the northbound side of the 110 freeway, and that is what you're seeing over on the left side. Those are the folks who just exited the 110 freeway north at Gage, and he is going to take the eastbound turn. So he's making a right turn eastbound on Gage into traffic here. So it's going to be a little bit slow. He's got traffic up ahead that he's now going to be encountering here, and now he's weaved back into his lane and just doing whatever it takes. You know, considering he's got a disabled vehicle here, he's still getting the most out of it in terms of him just kind of riding the wheel there over on the left rear. So he's not able to accelerate very quickly. He's just kind of leading the LAPD on a what you might consider at this point a slow speed chase. They are immediately behind him. In case this guy decides to foot bail, they're going to be right there behind him and ready to chase this guy down and perhaps the passenger as well. So it looks like there are at least two people inside the vehicle as he comes up. Okay, here we go. Cross traffic. Whoa! Woo! Okay, that's going to be Main Street. So he's going to cross. I do have you. Thank you. We're eastbound. Okay, slow speed, now eastbound on Gage. He just crossed over Broadway, and this is going to be a residential area here. And the cars that are ahead of him going westbound, they are all kind of pulling over at this point because they see what is coming their way. They see the LAPD helicopter. They see all the LAPD units on the ground, and they see this guy coming at him here. So, again, just a situation where some of the people are definitely watching what's going on here and pulling off to the right shoulder. So that's what's going on. He's through that intersection, and that is going to be Pedro. And he'll be heading over towards Avalon here now. Up ahead of him about half a block is going to be a lot of stop traffic. It's a red light up ahead, and we have a row of perhaps 20 vehicles here that are waiting for that stopped red light. And he's just going to go in the opposite lanes of traffic, and he's just going to plow right through there. So there you go, coming up on the intersection here. We have pedestrians crossing southbound and an LAPD unit. Oh, this is not going to be good. Okay, he's made that southbound turn on Avalon here. Southbound turn on Avalon. My gosh, you're seeing this. This is just unbelievable here, guys. Just refusing to give up. And you kind of wonder what is going on beyond just a stolen vehicle out of Pomona here. But again, southbound on Avalon, and we'll be coming up on Florence here in about three blocks. It's going to be the first major just on the south side of the postal annex. And we're continuing to watch as this guy leads us on this pursuit here. Okay. Okay. Thank you for that, Rich. What was that? I've got you. Thank you. It's okay. Okay, more smoke. Well, you're seeing it. Yeah, there you go. Blowing through that intersection here. You know, typically what we had seen here earlier on in this particular neighborhood is he would take us to about 90th, maybe a little bit past 90th, and find a way to kind of circle back northbound up towards Florence. But you kind of saw earlier some of the pedestrians who might have been nagging him on or intervening or interfering in some way. But I would have to believe that this is probably an area that he is familiar with, especially just along Avalon, south of Florence there. You see a lot of folks that are at the intersection of Avalon, and I think Rich told me 73rd, and a lot of people on the southeast corner of that intersection here who are kind of cheering him on. So again, I believe this is someone who is known in the neighborhood. I believe that this may be someone who is very familiar with the area, and he is just kind of circling back. I think at some point he's going to look to transition northbound. He's now made a right turn, and that is going to be westbound on Century here. Westbound on Century. I've not seen him come down this far south. But, well, there you go. He's kind of moving at a slow rate of speed. You will see intermittently some spurts of smoke coming from the left rear of the vehicle here. Of course, that would be from the brakes, perhaps, or from the wheel. That is now probably, you know, down to the drums at some point. But, you know, he's now making that westbound trek along Century Boulevard. He'll be over at Main Street shortly, and with the option, of course, of Main Street turning northbound or south or straight through. So we'll see what he does here. But not able to travel at freeway speed, at least not under any kind of control at this point here. You would think that in a turn, at a high-speed turn, he might actually lose control at some point because he's missing that left rear tire here. So you saw that turn kind of gingerly moving northbound here and accelerating probably as best he can here, but that is basically a slow move here. So we're talking about speeds 20, 30 miles an hour here now northbound from Century along Main Street here. So definitely an option, for him to just pull over and give up peacefully here. I think he's in it for the crowd. I think he's going to be heading back towards that area of familiarity over towards Avalon south of Florence, and we'll see what he does, but certainly he is kind of circling back and now northbound on Main Street, and he's going to be in the 90s pretty soon. Okay, he's already at 95th, so once he gets down to the 70s, he'll probably make a turn over towards the east, over towards Avalon, over towards the Postal Annex, but again, this is something that we have seen from him, just kind of that pattern of driving that we have observed for the past hour or so from Sky 5 HD here. So LAPD, again, still directly overhead. LAPD units on the ground, kind of staggering, at least five units on the ground who are in relative close proximity to him should he decide to come to a stop and foot bail here. Now, of course, there is that potential for two people to be running in case they do decide to foot bail here. But at some point, hopefully this truck will become completely disabled and this thing will come to an end here peacefully. But so far, we have seen by the actions of this driver, that is not going to be easy incoming here. It looks like did he make that right turn? He made the right turn in front of what I believe is a business complex or something, but he's heading into the neighborhood here. There he goes, popping out into the neighborhood, and that is going to be 87 here on the eastbound turn from Main Street here. So eastbound 87 from Main into the residential area, and he is going to be okay. Let's see what he does here. In another half a block, he's got an intersection. So my sense is that he's likely trying to get back towards the north here. So we'll see what he does. He might turn north here, or he might go over towards Avalon and turn north. But it looks like he's going to turn north right here, and that's going to be Pedro here. And once he comes out of those turns, if you've noticed coming out of the turns, it's a real slow go trying to get that truck moving once he starts out of that turn here. So again, that might be a situation where that left rear is really starting to go here. The tire's already been gone for about 10 minutes at this point here, but I can see LAPD is waiting up ahead of him at the intersection. Hang on, that's going to be coming up. Let me look over to the, okay, that's going to be Manchester coming up. So he's through Manchester, northbound here, and again, just a slow speed chase at this point, and likely a situation where he'd like to go faster but just can't. So we'll see what happens here. He's in that left turn pocket, but he's just going straight up San Pedro here through the 80s, 84th Street. And so at some point, he will be coming up on the 70s. And my sense is that he'll probably come up on a situation where he wants to make a right turn over towards Avalon, but we'll see kind of what happens here. But this is definitely moving into that area of familiarity that I believe that he was kind of making circles around. So again, we're just coming up on the southwest of Fremont High School, a couple of blocks away there. So we've been watching this kind of progression for the past hour, but just a not as dangerous a situation, but still very dangerous in that you can see the desperation that this guy has displayed here by some of the actions that he's put on display here. But is that white truck? The white truck, okay, if there's damage to the rear of that white truck, that is going to be the same truck here. So that white truck that was ahead of him, Rich Prickett or Sky 5, okay, hang on. Okay, hang on. Let me get north of the tree here. Five's got everyone. Okay, he's through the alley. Seven, I've got you. Okay, through a narrow alley, and he's going to be northbound just on the west side of San Pedro, and through the alley is going to be, this truck really has a hard time going here. once he comes out of the turn here, and I can actually see the fire coming from that left rear. Oh my gosh, you know, at some point, and it's going to be sooner than later, this thing is going to be over, but hopefully the LAPD is going to be able to box these guys in as they come out of the vehicle here. So it becomes more dangerous here in that, you know, the desperation that these guys have put on display. But you can see this thing is just barely crawling along. And at the end of this block, I can tell you there is another LAPD unit holding that block. So we are along 78. 78 between Pedro heading westbound towards Avalon here. So that's the direction that we're going here. So bear with us, actually towards Main Street. So in about 100 or maybe 200 yards, this guy is going to have to make a decision here. The LAPD does have that intersection more or less blocked off, but we'll see if this guy even has the momentum to even be able to do that. You can see the left rear tire. If you look close, there's fire there coming out of the left rear. So that thing is just really, really hot. So hopefully the LAPD will be able to get these guys to give up peacefully. Give up peacefully. Do the right thing here. Okay, there's the driver. Oh, my God. Two people running. They're westbound on 78. Westbound on 78 towards Main Street. LAPD is coming from Main Street on foot, and they are going to get these guys at some point here because there are a swarm of LAPD officers here who are working to tackle these two guys. So he's on the south side of the street, Rich. South side of the street. Right there. Okay, right at the gate, the other side of the gate, you have a dog. Okay, my goodness. Wow. Amazing work by the LAPD. Yeah, they were ahead of this guy because this one LAPD unit was actually ahead of the pursuit over on Main Street blocking off 78. And so that is just tells us that they knew kind of the general patterns here. So, wow, great job, guys. Great job. LAPD unit above, LAPD units on the ground. Amazing job by these guys. Both appear to be in custody here. Wow, you saw it, guys. If you widen out a little bit, Rich, are you actually looking at the arrest? Okay. If you widen out, it's getting crowded here. Rich, if you tilt up towards Main Street, it's a zoo. Okay. Seven, eight. Wow. Dang it. Oh, Rich. Wow. Dude. Okay.